So we started hurricane season pretty active, right? We had Alberto, Beryl, and Chris, but it's all quiet now. We still have very warm sea surface temperatures, these deep reds and purples here from the Gulf of Mexico out into the Atlantic, recognized temperatures that are above 80 degrees Fahrenheit. So warm water in place, we have that ingredient, but what's stopping storm development is Saharan dust traveling from the coast of Africa. You can see these yellow colors here as it spans across the Atlantic and then over toward Florida and the East Coast. This is a routine thing. It happens during the summertime. It peaks during the summertime until mid-August. And so as the trade winds push that along the Atlantic and this travels up 15,000 feet in the atmosphere, it prevents those clouds from developing and storms producing at this point in time. Going forward, we do look for the peak of hurricane season as we head into August and September, and formation in August becomes a little bit further away from the coast of the United States down toward the Caribbean and the Virgin Islands. And at this distance, those storms have more time to collect fuel, the warm, humid air, and develop into strong hurricanes before they move further inland. You can see here that the peak of hurricane season isn't until the middle of September, and then it declines after we head into October. So still have a couple months ahead. We are predicting an above average hurricane season. NOAA is expecting a 15 to 25 named storms, and so we do expect the Atlantic to become a little bit more active through the months to come. We'll keep you updated with any changes.